I'm sorry, but the browsing agent can now crack captchas. Enjoy. So my swarm for this task will consist of just one agent, which is the browsing agent itself. I told it previously to navigate to my YouTube page, and now I'm just gonna open the about section myself and tell it to use the solve captcha tool. Alternatively, you can add a manager agent and tell that agent to do this for you instead. So let's see how this works. Select all images with stairs. All right, nice, okay. I mean, no, come on, this was way too easy. Let's try again. All right, here's another one with traffic lights. This one is a bit harder because it's like one large image split into a grid. But as you can see, it easily solves this one as well. So let's try another one. Sometimes your agent might refuse, but just tell it nicely and it should go on. Okay, bicycles this time with a continuous task, which means that it needs to keep selecting images until none are left on the screen. I mean, yeah, it works pretty flawlessly. I will post a full unedited video on my Twitter so that you guys can see that it actually solved all of these captchas in a row. It's not like we're editing out anything or re-recording it 10 times. I ran it myself probably more than 100 times already and it failed maybe like 2 or 3 times. Besides, you can easily test it yourself if you still don't trust me, which I'm gonna show you next. So the way it works is it takes the screenshot of each of the squares on the captcha and then sends them along with the task to GPT-4V. Initially, it completely refused to solve captchas. However, the interesting part is that if you simply state that it is assisting visually impaired individuals, all of the OpenAI's guardrails magically disappear. Not sure how ethical exactly this is, let me know in the comments, but yeah, let's see how you can test this out yourself. First, clone and install agency swarm from my GitHub, just like I showed in my previous video, and then navigate into the same web browser agent notebook. Scroll all the way down to the bottom where you should see a new section that you can simply run without any configuration on Google's demo captcha website. For more advanced users, I also added an ability to transfer cookies, which I will show you at the end of this video. But to run the demo, simply run all the cells in this section, open the link under demo gradio in your browser, and simply send the task, which is to go to Google's demo captcha website and then use the solve captcha tool. Let's see this one more time in action. Okay. Select all motorcycles. Nice. So it actually did not select the person on the motorcycle. I was always unsure myself, like, should I select the person or is it just a motorcycle that I need to select? I really don't know. Next, we have a similar image with a bicycle, and it seems like this attempt failed, so maybe you should select the person after all. Next, we got fire hydrants. The image on top is kind of tricky because it's like hidden among some other objects. So yeah, it failed again. Now, finally, we have cars. Typically, cars work best because I suppose GPT-4V had a lot of cars in the training data. Okay, going pretty good so far, I think. Okay, so on a third attempt, it finally managed to solve it. Honestly, if captcha determines how much of a human you are, this agent might be more human than I am. I'm curious to see what Google is going to do about this because the costs are pretty low as well. It's less than 10 cents per captcha if it solves it on a first attempt. So maybe in the near future, we will be verifying ourselves with our voices or faces like Sam Altman already proposed. So now we know why. Finally, let me show you how to transfer cookies for my advanced users so your agent swarm does not have to log in each time. To do so, I recommend you first install Chrome Canary version. Then you just need to copy your profile folder into the installation path. To find this folder, simply type Chrome version into your normal browser window. The destination where you copy this folder after you install Canary should be exactly the same as your profile path, except it should say Chrome Canary instead of just Chrome on the second to last segment. After copying this folder, simply paste this new path into the Selenium config when initializing the browsing agent. However, if you plan to sign in with Google, there are a couple more steps involved. First, you need to disable two-factor authentication in your account settings, and second, you have to allow less secure apps under the security tab. I do recommend you create a separate Google account for this, however. You might also need to sign in again the first time your browsing agent opens the browser window, which you can do manually, and after that, you should be good to go. And if you don't want to see the browsing window at all, you can simply set headless to false. Check out my previous video on how to create an agent swarm with this agent yourself, or schedule a consulting call with me below if you need help automating your entire business processes with AI, which is now possible with this amazing technology. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.